Hello again, this is Charles Anderson in the fifth of my talks, quick talks about ACM and some of the ways in which you can use it. You'll remember from the last webinar I did, there was a flow sheet that I put together in which I'd put in economics and had a look at how the plant performed as I made a series of changes to the process conditions. That was all interacting directly with ACM. But occasionally it's useful to share those results with other people who maybe don't have a modeling background. So one of the things that ACM does is give you a fairly nice visual basic interface that allows you to pull data out of ACM and put it into Excel. So what I've done, I'm not going to go into the details of Excel in this case, but I'll give you a couple of quick ideas as to some of the things that I've done using that feature. So what I've done here is I've created an Excel VBA toolset where what I can do is I can list a series of variables from ACM. So you can see many of these variables here, annual operating hours, price of raw materials, those sort of things. I'm pulling into the spreadsheet here. I've got a column for the units in which to do that. So if I want to show that in non-standard units, I can switch out those units. And then I've got a series of columns where these are automatically written by Excel when I click a button. So if I pull data from ACM, it'll ask me what file would you like to pull from? And I want to pull it from this whole plant one folder, so that's good. I'm going to compare results, so I'm going to create case 9. And I've just written a script that lets me change that out. I pull the ACM data, and it's saying I've got the wrong file open. So let me just double check, make sure I've got the correct file open. I think that's the one I'm actually using now. And so what it's doing now is it's going away, it's asking ACM for the results, and then writing all those results. And here I've got the test. And what it's done is it's added another column worth of data onto these tabs that I've colored pink just so I can find them quickly. And so that's giving me a whole bunch of information about the different cases. That's somewhat useful in and of itself. But the nice thing about having that data in Excel is that I can then tidy it up and make it look pretty. So what I've done is here, for example, I've pulled some of the key information, and then I've formatted it so I can see as I've gone through the ACM cases what have I done. So I'm picking up, I'm using the offset function of Excel to get the description that I provided for the different cases, and then I'm using the offset to choose the right column from this raw data tab and work out exactly how things are going on. So this has given me a nice clean way of comparing the different cases. If you remember in scenario 4, I started off with a base case that was relatively expensive in terms of the cost of manufacturing. And then I did things like change the duration of the reactor, change the temperature of the reactor, turn on various recycles, avoid sending material to waste. And you can see I was able to pull down the cost fairly substantially. And of course, once I've got it in this format, I can set up pie charts to look at how things change and write little cute scripts to show you how, as I move through the cases, that breakdown of costs changes. So you can see where the money's going as I do things. So that's a high level of you sort of comparing directly the cases. Of course, I can then pull stream summaries. So if I'm trying to communicate with an engineering team who are interested in a high-level process flow diagram, maybe of the key streams that are going on, I can pull together that composition, temperature kind of stream table. And again, I've written little bits and pieces of Visual Basic that let me change that to update the table for the different scenarios that I've run. I can pull equipment summaries, so I've got sizing of equipment here, which maybe I can then use to come up with capital estimates. I've got operating costs, so if I know the unit cost and what it's costing me, I can roll that up together to get me my cost per kilo, my operating cost per kilo, my operating cost per pound, and of course then sort of see how that changes as I go through the different scenarios. So quick overview there. I know I zipped through a lot of stuff, but what you're seeing is that that Excel interface from ACM allows you to then sort of summarize out the data, the straight engineering data that you had in ACM, pull it into Excel so that it's cleanly formatted, and then transform it into the sort of format that is maybe easier for financial people, business people to look at, and or for other engineers to sort of review and maybe provide detailed capital cost estimating, that sort of thing, on the data. Okay, that's it for number 5. Hope that's useful. Bye.